Hey guys, I'm so excited about today's topic because I have been feeling more tired than usual. I don't know if you have been feeling that way, but today's topic is fatigue. We're talking about why we feel that sense of fatigue and what we can do about it. So I'm Lindsay Mitchell with Vitalside. With us, we have Jonathan Parr with Parr PT, and we're going to sort of debunk this idea of how our brains and bodies experience fatigue. And so from my understanding, when we experience this place of feeling fatigue all the time, oftentimes it's because we're in this response of fight, flight, freeze. And it's sort of this freeze element that we experience. And we get into this state of fight, flight, freeze when we experience something traumatic, like this pandemic, or chronic symptoms, chronic pain, fatigue, inflammation. And this can keep us stuck in this state of fight, flight, freeze. Well, the reason why we experience this freeze component is often because we are experiencing this HPA axis on overdrive. And this is the hypothalamus pituitary adrenal axis. And this is the axis that keeps us stuck in a state of stress when we experience trauma, when we hear the word pandemic, when we're dealing with a chronic illness day in and day out. And when we have that increase in cortisol and that's kind of running through our bodies, we're getting that response that we're in that state of stress. We can have that cortisol overload and it can cause burnout, right? And I see it with clients who experience this sense of burnout, this sense of fatigue in the brain. And Jonathan, I'm sure you kind of see this in your clients who experience this sense of fatigue in the body, right?
Exactly. So, I mean, you hit the nail on it. When you're having so much fatigue and you're expending so much energy, we look at it from a functional standpoint. How much energy are you really expending to do something what we would think as simple? So going from your bed to your kitchen, kitchen to your mailbox. And a lot of these maybe shorter distance activities is causing enough exhaustion related to or comparable to is, you know, if you were to run 5 or 6 miles when it's a shorter distance. And your body is really good at telling you these things, that when you go from point A to point B, if something's not right, your body's going to respond with that, you know, that sympathetic response, releasing and a bunch of, you know, different chemicals and reacting different ways. And that's telling you, hey, I need to slow down. But also it's telling me that maybe I'm lacking a part of my movement patterns, or maybe I'm moving in a way that's just taking so much energy that it's just causing me to stress out more and more, that I may need to consult a clinician that is familiar with, you know, these kind of responses related to movement. And you know, by being able to get into something that's slow and progressive in conjunction with other, you know, stress relief activities or stress response activities that will correlate together, you start to basically rebuild that foundation that allows you to function just on a day-to-day basis.
Yeah. I think it's important to know that there is this sympathetic dominance or autonomic nervous system dysregulation associated with fatigue. And you know, there are things that you can do to address that, but it is important to also understand what is safe for you and what makes sense, you know, for your own body type. So that's really cool. Well, something that you can use today is making a change to your physiological state. So in Vitalside, I call them state-changing exercises. So let's run through one together so that we can learn how to make a change to our physiological state right now. So, you know, if you're listening at home, just go ahead and follow along. Let's sit up straight, you know, telling our body that we're prioritizing this information, and go ahead and start to inhale and exhale 3 seconds each. So inhale for three and exhale for three. And continue in this way. And you can close your eyes if that feels comfortable. And to counteract fatigue today, what I'd like you to do is start to visualize the color yellow moving in through your body, in through your heart. And the color yellow being exhaled to the rest of your body. And continue breathing in and exhaling in this way. And the color yellow signals vitality, happiness, and vibrancy. And when we're coming from a place of autonomic nervous system dysfunction and experiencing fatigue, we can feel a sense of disempowerment. So go ahead and breathe in that yellow. In through your heart and exhale it out the rest of your body. And if you continue to do this, you know, just for a couple of minutes, you're doing a few things there. You're kind of syncing up your heartbeat with your brain waves. And it's this creating this heart-brain coherence, which is really, really interesting. And, you know, there's so much research on that. So if you want more information on that, feel free to reach out. I'm Lindsay at My Vital Side, and we have with us Jonathan Parr PT Austin. If you have any questions, feel free to message us on Facebook or Instagram. Thank you, guys.